Hello guys, Aloy Andalus from MVFX and Effective Technical Directors. Today we will talk about enhancements on viewports on 3ds Max 2020.2. We will talk about workflows on OSL, and we will talk about PBR. PBR stands for Pabst Blue Ribbon, maybe not. It stands for Physical Based Rendering, and we will see how we use that in 3ds Max, because there is people that doesn't know that it's totally usable in 3ds Max, and you will get experience similar to you will get on a real-time engine, and we will see how to do that. So let's start. You need to use physical material to get the best of your shaders on the viewport. Physical material is compatible with Arnold Art, Quicksilver, V-Ray, Final Render, and some others. If you use the materials from each renderer, that like V-Ray material, it's possible that some features are not compatible on the viewport, so maybe you will not get the roughness on the viewport. Physical material is compatible with all of that, so I recommend using it. Next thing to do is set your viewport to high quality. This will create nice shadows, and it will convert the shaders to HLSL. We have the default lights on our scene. Let's create one light. Spotlight is good for the sun. If you need to create soft shadows, create a photometric light instead and set it to area light. To see some of the improvements, turn off the light. So right now there is no light. It's the information that you see is coming from reflections. You need to open your environment panel with 8, and now on the background color, if you change it, you get automatically IBL illumination. So basically the background color is illuminating your scene. All the light information comes from this background color. It's similar as if you create a sky dome. If you select an HDR image for the background, it will be used both for illumination and reflection. You will see that the shadows will change depending on the HDR. So all the shadows that you can see comes from the HDR. And if you want to adjust that, you need to create a skylight. With the skylight, you will be able to turn off the IBL illumination, but to keep the reflections, or you can adjust the intensity of this HDR illumination. At any point, you can create a camera, and remember that you can have depth of field to turn on, and you can adjust this depth of field using the aperture. Your camera target will be the focus of your depth of field. This gives us a nice cinematographic look to your viewport. Now that we have our environment set up, it's time to apply our materials. There are multiple ways to set up our materials. Now, if you come to this video, maybe it's because the PBR. PBR means physical based rendering, and it's basically a concept. There is no hard rules written about PBR. The main goal goes to mimic the physical real materials in a computer way, but at the same time it's easily artistic controllable. Substance software make it quite popular, and all the real-time engines spread the world of PBR. They are inspired by the Disney principal shader BRDF. If you know Blender, Blender uses the principal shader that is also based on the same, and physical material in 3ds Max is also based on this Disney principal shader. The basic concept of PBR is that everything is shiny. In these two examples, if I ask you which one reflects and which one not, maybe you will tell me that the car reflects while the t-shirt doesn't reflect. But in PBR, or in reality, is that if you see color, it's because there is a reflection of light. The difference is that on the left, the car, the surface of reflectance is perfectly flat, so the incident rays expose a perfect deflection ray. So the reflection is sharp. On the t-shirt example, we have reflection as well. The difference is that our surface is not perfectly flat. It has some roughness, can be at the microscopic level. So when the incident light hits the surface, instead of reflecting on a perfect ray, it spreads totally. So the light of light gets diffused. It's what we call a roughness surface. I will say these are the basic concepts to understand PBR. I will add some links to more advanced descriptions below that you can read if you want to know more about it. So let's start. The only thing that was missing in 3ds Max was the roughness representation on viewport. In 3ds Max 2020.2, they add this support, so now on the viewport we can display roughness in a correct way. The basic textures that you will see on a PBR material will be the base texture, also called diffuse or albedo. Albedo technically is something different than diffuse, but most of the time it's just the same name for both things. It's basically the color without information of shadows or environment reflections. Then we have the roughness map. As we saw, this map tells us if the light is reflected over a surface that is flat, or if it's reflected about a surface with microfacets that will spread the light. Sometimes we will have metallic textures. These normally are black or white, defining if material is metallic or non-metallic. Metallic materials are electrically conductive and they absorb rather than scatter light, so they behave a little different. They are usually highly reflective. Before, it would be like having a lot of index of reflection. Finally, we have the normal texture, because PBR is very used in games, normally you will have normals to give more detail to your material. These are some of the most usual maps, but remember that there is no hard rule about PBR, and you will find a lot of other additional information to create a PBR material, like SSS, transparency, height, emission, refraction, and others. So now we only need to connect all these textures to our physical material. Remember on diffuse to turn on auto gamma, but then all the other data, remember to turn off auto gamma or set gamma to 1. Thanks to OSL bitmap, the gamma control is much more accessible than before. With OSL, we can add, for example, tweak colors, and we can change the color of our material very easily. This is because with realistic and OSL, we are doing an HLSL conversion, so it's way faster than before. At the same time, you can do the same with the roughness of the material. So, decreasing roughness with the tweak colors as well, we can have or a very reflective car in this case, or we can increase roughness and have a very roughness car, so you can see that the reflection ray gets spread. With OSL we can access multiple scene information. For example, we can access wireframe color information. So, even if we have the same material applied to all the objects, changing our wireframe color will affect, in this case, the diffuse, but you can affect the reflection or roughness or whatever of your material per object with one single material. That's super cool. On the legacy bitmap, we had the UVs embed on the same bitmap. Now with OSL, UVs are outside, so we can do cool stuff. What we have is that we access the UVs from our object, but we displace it with a noise OSL. We can get some wet effects, and you can do it on the diffuse, you can do it on the reflection or whatever. Before, if we want texture variations, we had to create different materials. With OSL, it's not anymore the case. We have, for example, here three different textures. We plug it into a switch. Then we use a node hash, so it's accessing the name of our objects. And then we plug it into a randomize. This randomize, we connect it to the switcher, so it will switch automatically to this leaf. You will see that it will update, so now each leaf has a different texture. You can duplicate this as many times as you want, and each leaf will get a different color. Something that you can do is like, since this rely on a hash name, if two objects has the same name, they will get the same texture. This can be useful in some cases. So now we can have random values per object. Why stop here? Basically, you can use a UV transform, accessing the UV transformations of each object, and plug this random value. So now each object will have a different UV information. We plug it right now on the offset, but you can plug it on the scale of the UVs or on the rotation of the UVs. The cool thing is that now you have infinite number of UVs per object. So you can duplicate this object as many times as you want, and you don't need to reapply or create different types of material. With one single material, you can apply it to thousands of objects, and you know that each object will have a slightly different variation. You can add variation on the color, on the diffuse, on the reflections, on the UVs as you want. OSL is super powerful for all these purposes and give us a lot of flexibility now. So OSL, the cool thing is that you can as well edit these maps, but as we saw on these examples, even if you don't want to go inside the coding aspect, with all the already shipped OSL materials in 3ds Max, you can do much more than before. Physical material is compatible with most renderers. You can see here on the detachable viewport that it's new as well on Max 2020.2, we have Arnold rendering, and we have the viewport background. And as you can see, if I tweak anything on OSL, it translates exactly. The roughness is the same. You can tweak roughness as well on the viewport, and you will see the translation almost one-to-one. The latest Arnold GPU supports OSL, but some other renderers, maybe on the GPU version, doesn't support yet OSL, so you will need to check it out that. Now that the viewport is very nice, maybe you don't need to render anymore, so you can always do a make preview, that it's been improved a lot on 2020.2 as well. with JPEG sequence will be way faster. Just increase the quality of the image so the progressive renderer will kick in more time and you will get a nicer refinement of the shadows and everything. And that's all. Then do a JPEG, PNG, and you will have your render. You can as well use Quicksilver, that it's kind of the same as the Make Preview. Shangso Eun has an article talking about OSL in 3ds Max and how it changed workflows. I think it's super cool, I will have the description below. And done! Let me know in the comments if you already use OSL or PBR workflows in 3ds Max. It will be cool to discuss that. And thank you a lot to all my Patreon supporters, they have these videos before everyone. And it helps me a ton. Thank you a lot to them. If you are not on Patreon, please consider giving a donation. If not, super happy to be increasing the community around 3ds Max. And see you soon, guys.